Very good afternoon. This is the midday news on Rajya Sabha TV. All the developing news stories at the top of one. Coming up ahead, let us start with the headlines. Innovation and aspirations of India's youth to fuel dream of $5 trillion economy, says Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the convocation ceremony of IIT Madras. Proposes a hackathon for ASEAN countries on the lines of India-Singapore hackathon. Rafale to be a game changer for the Indian Air Force, says new Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria, asserts Indian Defence Forces ready to tackle any challenge. Jammu Kashmir Block Development Council elections on 24th of October. Amit Shah says no restrictions in Kashmir, expresses confidence that the region will be the most developed in the country in the next 10 years. Prime Minister Modi chairs BJP meet to select candidates for Maharashtra and Haryana polls. Congress names a 51 candidates for Maharashtra. Fields a former Chief Minister Ashok Chavan from Bhokar seat. And rains in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar claim over 120 lives in the last 4 days. Red alert in 15 Bihar districts. Patna among worst affected, schools and colleges shut. State authorities step up rescue work. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today addressed the annual convocation of the Indian Institute of Technology in Madras, and addressing the students, Prime Minister Modi said that they are graduating at a time when the world is looking at India as a land of unique opportunities. He said this during his meetings with the heads of state, business leaders, innovators and entrepreneurs in the United States. He said that the common thread during his meetings in the US was optimism about new India and confidence in the abilities of the Indian young people. He said that innovation, aspiration and application of technology by the youth will fuel the dream of India becoming a $5 trillion economy. He also urged the students to find environmentally friendly replacement for single-use plastics.
Today, as India is inspiring to become a $5 trillion economy, your innovation, aspiration, and application of technology will fuel this dream. It become the bedrock of India's big leap into the most competitive economy. Friends, IIT Madras is a prime example of how a decade-old institution can transform itself to meet the needs and aspirations of the 21st century.
And Prime Minister Narendra Modi also addressed the Singapore-India hackathon at IIT Madras, where he hailed the India's innovation ecosystem and said that it was committed to creating Indian solutions for global applications. He also proposed a hackathon involving ASEAN nations to find solutions to tackle global warming and climate change. The hackathon at IIT Madras, conducted over the last weekend, was the second India-Singapore initiative to foster innovation through contests.
Indian solutions for global application. This is our goal and our commitment. We would also like our cost-effective solutions to be available to serve the needs of the poorest countries. India innovation in support of the poorest and the most deprived, no matter where they live. Friends, I genuinely believe that technology unites people even across countries, across continents. I welcome the suggestions of Minister Aung. Let me take this opportunity to propose a similar hackathon involving those ASEAN countries that may be interested in participating with support from NGO, Government of Singapore and Government of India. Let best brain in ASEAN countries compete to offer innovative solution for reducing global warming and climate change.
On to some other news, Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria took charge as the 26th Chief of the Indian Air Force today. He succeeds Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanoha, who retired after 41 years of service in the Indian Air Force. Air Marshal Bhadauria was commissioned in the fighter stream of the Indian Air Force in June 1980 and has held various command, staff and instructional positions. Bhadauria is one of the few Air Force pilots to fly a Rafale jet. An alumnus of the National Defence Academy or the NDA, he won the coveted Sword of Honour for standing first in the overall order of merit. And during his nearly four-decade career, Bhadauria commanded a Jaguar squadron and a Premier Air Force station. He devised a method for carrying a bombing from the Jaguar aircraft using the GPS, that is the Global Positioning System.
Indian Air Force being one of the finest air forces of the world. As far as Rafale is concerned, Rafale is a very capable aircraft. We have said so before. Once we induct it, it will be a game changer in terms of our capability, operational capability. And once we use it in conjunction with other aircraft like the Su-30 and other fleets that we have, we would have a serious jump in our operational capability.
On to some election-related news now, BJP's Central Election Committee met on Sunday to finalise the candidates for the assembly elections in Maharashtra and Haryana. The meeting was attended by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Home Minister Amit Shah and BJP Working President JP Nadda. And according to sources, BJP's seat-sharing arrangement with the Shiv Sena in Maharashtra will be announced in a couple of days. The Shiv Sena is likely to field candidates for around 120 to 125 seats in the 288-member Maharashtra Assembly. The party has already started distributing tickets even before the formal seat-sharing announcement, including a ticket for Aditya Thackeray from the Worli Assembly constituency in Mumbai. Aditya will be the first member of the Thackeray clan ever to contest an election. While Devendra Fadnavis remains BJP's face in the Maharashtra polls, Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar is the party's face in the state. Khattar is expected to contest from Karnal, a seat from where he had won in 2014. Remember, both these states are going to polls on 21st of October. And the Congress Party also released the first list of 51 candidates for the upcoming assembly elections in Maharashtra. And former Chief Minister Ashok Chavan will contest from the Bhokar seat in Nanded district. And former Minister Nitin Raut is going to contest from Nagpur North Assembly constituency. The party has fielded former Chief Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde's daughter Praniti Shinde from Solapur City Central seat. And former Chief Minister Vilas Rao Deshmukh's son, Amit Deshmukh, from the Latur city seat. And both BJP and Congress have also named their candidates for the upcoming assembly by-polls. BJP has announced the names of 38 nominees for the assembly by-elections to be held across several states on 21st of October. Former Congress MLAs, including Alpesh Thakur, were among the six candidates named by the BJP for by-polls in Gujarat. The party has fielded Sweety Singh from Kishanganj in Bihar, Suresh Tiwari from Lucknow Kant seat. And the Congress party also released a list of candidates for by-polls to a Lok Sabha seat and various assembly constituencies in Gujarat, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan. Saeeda Banu is contesting from Kishanganj assembly seat in Bihar. Rita Chaudhary from Mandawa in Rajasthan, Harendra Mirdha from Kinshwar Assembly constituency in Rajasthan, and Manu Devi for the Balha SC Assembly segment in Uttar Pradesh. Names of four nominees for the upcoming Gujarat Assembly by-polls have also been announced. By-polls will be held for 51 Assembly seats on 21st of October. along with the state elections in Haryana and Maharashtra. The Election Commission has reduced Sikkim Chief Minister Prem Singh Tamang's disqualification period by 5 years. The Election Commission moved under a provision of an electoral law that paved the way for him to contest the state assembly elections. Now, his disqualification period of 6 years had begun on 10th of August 2018, the day he completed a jail's term in a corruption case, and it was to end on 10th of August 2024. However, the Election Commission has reduced it to 1 year and 1 month. Tamang took over as the Chief Minister on 27th of May, but he could not contest the elections due to his disqualification. He had to contest the assembly polls within 6 months of becoming the Chief Minister to hold the office. Remember, he was found guilty of a misappropriation of government funds in a cow distribution scheme while he was the Minister of Animal Husbandry in 1990s. News from Jammu and Kashmir, where dates have been announced for the election of chairpersons of BDC, that is the Block Development Councils, in 310 blocks of Jammu and Kashmir. Now, Chief Electoral Officer for Jammu and Kashmir, Shailendra Kumar, said on Sunday that notification for the election will be issued on 1st of October, and 9th of October will be the last date for filing of nominations. Polling will be held on 24th of October from 9 in the morning to 1 in the afternoon, and the counting of votes will begin at 3 p.m. the same day. Elections will be held through ballot boxes. Over 26,000 panchas and sarpanchas are eligible to vote and contest for the post of BDC chairpersons.
So, chairperson for Block Development Council ka election party basis par hone ka hai. टोटल 316 ब्लॉक्स हैं स्टेट में, जिसमें से कि 310 पर इलेक्शन होंगे, दो जगह, एक कुलगाम में और एक श्रीनगर में, जहां पर कि कोई भी पंच या सरपंच नहीं चुना गया था, और चार ऐसी सीट्स जिस पर कि विमेन कैंडिडेट के लिए रिजर्व है और उसमें कोई विमेन नहीं है. सो टोटल 6 काउंसिल के इलेक्शन नहीं हो सकेंगे, 310 पर इलेक्शन होंगे.
And Home Minister Amit Shah has said that the decision of abrogation of Article 370 and 35A from Jammu and Kashmir is the best tribute to thousands of martyrs of CRPF. Speaking at the 27th Raising Day celebrations of the Rapid Action Force RAF at Vastral in Ahmedabad in Gujarat, Amit Shah said that Jammu and Kashmir will now be on the new path of peace and prosperity. Amit Shah said that Prime Minister Modi recently inaugurated the National Police Memorial in Delhi to mark the supreme sacrifices by CRPF jawans. Home Minister said that Prime Minister Modi will also launch the logo of the National Police Memorial on 31st of October, on the birth anniversary of Sardar Patel.
Kashmir ko डिस्टर्ब करने की जिसकी भी नियत है, उसको हमारे सुरक्षा बल ढंग से उसका जवाब देंगे, और वहां पर एक चीरकाल के लिए शांति प्रस्तापित करने में हमारी हमें सफलता मिलेगी. प्रधानमंत्री जी ने धारा 370 और 35A को हटाकर कश्मीर में एक परमानेंट शांति, एक निरंतर शांति की शुरुआत कर सकती है. इतने सारे जवानों का बलिदान हमसे मांग कर कि कश्मीर के अंदर एक स्थिति ऐसी निर्मित की जाए जो हमेशा के लिए शांति बनी रहे, जवानों को जान गंवाने का मौका न बारी न आए, जवानों को वहां व्यवस्था देखने के लिए, कश्मीर का नजारा देखने का मौका मिले. इस प्रकार के कश्मीर की रचना करने का ये सभी बलिदानी हमसे मांग करते.
More news related to Jammu and Kashmir. The Supreme Court has referred a batch of petitions challenging the abrogation of Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir to its constitution bench. The bench would hear the matter from Tuesday. A bench headed by Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi referred the pleas to its five-judge bench. A five-judge constitution bench headed by Justice N.V. Ramanna will hear the matters related to Kashmir issue from Tuesday. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has lauded Prime Minister Narendra Modi for championing the cause of peace and prosperity for larger good at the 74th UNGA session. In a Facebook post, the Vice President said that Prime Minister Modi effectively unveiled India's vision for peace and development for humanity, in contrast to the mindset that believes in violence, terrorism and warmongering for short-sighted vested interests. He said that Prime Minister Modi gave a crisp account of the unfolding India development narrative that is aimed at achieving sustainable development goals. In Midday News, time to take a very short break. We'll be right back with more news.
Million people have now given the thumbs up to Rajya Sabha television. RSTV's growth has been phenomenal, with the journey from 2 million to 3 million being completed in less than 6 months. That's over 6,200 new subscribers every day. Our online viewers are engaging with us more actively. Every day, thousands like, share and comment on our videos. So come and join this growing tribe of RSTV viewers and get ready for an exciting journey.
In the Mann Ki Baat address on Sunday, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that e-cigarettes were banned to prevent the youth from falling into the new way of intoxication. Urging people to shun tobacco, the Prime Minister warned that e-cigarettes, which are used as a fashion statement, are a new way of getting addicted to nicotine.
Yuva pidhi desh ka bhavishya hai. E-cigarette par pratibandh lagaya gaya hai taki नशे का यह नया तरीका हमारे युवा देश को तबाह न कर दे, हर परिवार के सपनों को रौंद न डाले, बच्चों की जिंदगी बर्बाद न हो जाए। ये बीमारी, ये आदत समाज में जड़े न जमा दे। मैं आप सभी से यह आग्रह करता हूं कि तंबाकू के व्यसन को छोड़ दें और ई सिगरेट के संबंध में कोई गलतफहमी न पाले। आइए हम सब मिलकर एक स्वस्थ भारत का निर्माण करें।
Prime Minister Modi also talked about plogging, a combination of jogging and picking up litter, and hailed the efforts of Ripudaman Belvi, who has launched a campaign to pick up litter while jogging. He said that a campaign to shun single-use plastic is set to be launched on Gandhi Jayanti.
हम सबको ये करना है कि हम 2 किलोमीटर तक जॉगिंग भी करें और रास्ते में पड़े प्लास्टिक के कचरों को भी जमा करें। इससे हम न केवल अपनी सेहत का ख्याल रखेंगे बल्कि धरती माँ की सेहत की भी रक्षा कर सकेंगे। इस अभियान से लोगों में फिटनेस के साथ साथ स्वच्छता को लेकर भी जागरूकता बढ़ रही है। मुझे विश्वास है कि 130 करोड़ देशवासी इस दिशा में एक कदम उठाएंगे तो सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक की मुक्त होने की दिशा में अपना भारत 130 करोड़ कदम आगे बढ़ जाएगा।
He also appealed to the people to participate in the Run for Unity event slated to be held on 31st of October. And referring to the festival season, the Prime Minister also reminded listeners about the rich-poor divide and said there should be an out-delivery of gifts and sweets.
Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat, ye hum sabka sapna hai. Aur usi nimitt, har varsh 31 October ko, hum pure desh mein Run for Unity, desh ki ekta ke liye daud. अबाल वृद्ध सब लोग स्कूल कॉलेज सब हजारों की तादाद में हिंदुस्तान के लाखों गांवों में उस दिन देश की एकता के लिए हमें दौड़ना है। तो आप अभी से तैयारी शुरू कीजिए,
विस्तार से तो बात आगे जरूर करूंगा, लेकिन अभी समय है, कुछ लोग प्रैक्टिस भी शुरू कर सकते हैं, कुछ योजना भी कर सकते हैं। खेल त्योहारों का माहौल फिर एक बार नए उमंग, नई ऊर्जा, नया उत्साह, नए संकल्प से भर जाएगा। फेस्टिवल सीजन है ना, आगे कई हफ्तों तक देश भर में त्योहारों की रौनक रहेगी। हम सभी नवरात्रि महोत्सव, गरबा, दुर्गा पूजा, दशहरा, दिवाली, भैया दूज, छठ पूजा, अनगिनत त्योहार मनाएंगे। आप सभी को आने वाले त्योहारों की ढेर सारी शुभकामनाएं।
And Union Minister Dr. Harshvardhan on Sunday reviewed the ongoing beautification work at Naini Jheel of Model Town in New Delhi. Recently, a team from a National Environmental Engineering Research Institute collected a water sample from the lake to check its biological oxygen demand level for the survival of the aquatic life. After the visit, Dr. Harshvardhan said that Model Town will soon be known across India because of Naini Jheel. He said, Prime Minister Modi's ideas of Swachh Bharat was the driving force behind the revival of the lake. He further revealed that the administration also plans to introduce boating in the lake once the work is completed.
आप देख रहे हैं कि इसकी जो है शेप कैसे बदली है, विज्ञान और टेक्नोलॉजी का भी प्रयोग करके इसमें हमारी जो नेशनल एनवायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग रिसर्च जो इंस्टीट्यूशन है CSIR की नागपुर की, उनके वैज्ञानिकों ने भी यहाँ पर देखा, अपने फ्लोटर्स जो पानी के अंदर एकदम उत्साहित हो जाते हैं हर्षो उल्लास से, जिसे कहते हैं कि उन फ्लोटर्स को भी एक बहुत बड़ा जीवन मिलता है और साथ में जो लेक की सफाई में भी सहायक होते हैं उनका इस्तेमाल भी इसमें किया जा रहा है।
Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla on Sunday attended a reception organized by the Indian diaspora in Uganda. Om Birla is in the African country to attend the 64th Commonwealth Parliamentary Conference, and he said that Indian diaspora has contributed immensely to their adopted countries, not only economically but also socially. Lok Sabha MP Adhiranjan Chaudhary, Rajya Sabha MP Rupa Ganguly, Rajya Sabha MP Dr. L. Halumantayya, Lok Sabha MP Aparajita Sarangi and Odisha Assembly Speaker Dr. Surya Narayana Patro also attended the reception. And Vice President M.K. Naidu inaugurated the famous dance Shri Ram at Shri Ram Kala Kendra Center in New Delhi on Sunday. This is the 63rd edition of the dance drama. Vice President M.K. Naidu said that Ramayana is a heritage of the entire mankind. He called for efforts to preserve, propagate and deepen people's understanding of the immortal epic. He asserted that the Ramayana reminds people of their duty towards the world, society and family. The Vice President urged everyone to take a small steps daily for common good, steps like controlling pollution, saving water, preserving the environment to make the world a better place. The event started on 29th of September and will conclude on 25th of October.
Undoubtedly, Ramayana is a heritage. Make the best efforts to preserve, propagate and deepen our understanding of this immortal epic. The sublimity and creativity of a culture is reflected in its art forms, its literature, its music, folklores and crafts. Often these art forms, folklores and music develop around a central character which carries all that is deemed as virtuous in a tradition.
At least 120 people have died in rain-related incidents across Uttar Pradesh and Bihar in the last 4 days as heavy rains continue to wreak havoc in several parts of eastern India. At least 14 people have been killed in Bihar. Heavy rains continue to batter Patna, where 3 days of heavy downpour has flooded homes and hospitals. According to the Met Department, Patna has received more than 200 mm of rainfall since Friday evening. And 87 people have died in neighboring Uttar Pradesh in the last 4 days in rain-related incidents in the state, out of which 14 people have died in the last 24 hours. The deaths have been caused due to wall collapses, snake bites, drowning and lightning in the state. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has directed that relief work should be accelerated and ensuring that no shortage of food material in the flood-affected areas takes place. Let's get you some sports news now. News from football, where India defeated Bangladesh by 2-1 in the final of SAF Under 18 Championships 2019 to lift the trophy on Sunday. From the beginning, India played aggressively and Vikram Pratap Singh did not take much time to hand India a 1-0 lead. Singh scored in the second minute of the match. And in the second half, both the teams gave each other tough competition and restricted each other from scoring a goal. However, it was India's Ravi Bahadur Rana who broke the deadlock by scoring a goal which sealed his team's victory in the match. This is the first time that India has clinched this title. And this victory comes in the back of India winning the Under-15 SAF Championship as well, beating Bangladesh in the final in the month of August. And that is the wrap on this edition of Midday News. Thanks for watching.